To do it. Mm-hmm. But he did it anyway.
So
for his mercy. And his grace abounds forever.
Yes.
And we know that nothing happens without his approval. So as we bow our heads, close our eyes, even where we sit, knowing that you hear our prayer, and prayer does change things. He said that his word would not go out and come back void. So, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the giver and the sustainer of life, the author and the finisher of our faith, the great I am, the Alpha and Omega, the Rose of Sharon, the great Jehovah Jireh. He is our provider. He's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. He is our everything. We can lean and depend on him. He promised that he would never leave us nor forsake us. And oh Father, we stand in the gap of those who are unable to receive your blessings. But Father, you saw fit and you selected each one of us to be set apart in your name, that we can live and be in your atmosphere. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord, that you looked down and said, give me a body and I'll go down and redeem man. Oh, Father, times are not easy. Times are rough. Times are confusing. Times is fear. But you said, Lord, with you all things are possible. You said, look to the hills from which cometh our help. And all of our help cometh from you. You said that though these worms destroy this body, yet in our flesh we shall see you for ourselves and not another. Mary, Mary, I am the resurrection and the life, that he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. Why, Pastor? Because thou art with me. Oh, thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Giving your darling son Jesus as a sacrifice. To let us know that now we have eternal life. Lord, Lord, looking for that great resurrection. Well, Father, we will stand in the arms and the bosom of Abraham. Oh, Lord, thank you, Father, for sealing us this morning, knowing that we could have been anywhere else. But, Father, we chose to worship you. Just want to say thank you, Lord, for the many ways that you have blessed us, in the ways that you put clothes on our back, you put food on our table, you heal our bodies, you deliver us from the snares of the evil one. Oh, Father, we just want to say thank you for blessing us today. And Lord, those outside the walls of this edifice, that you may open their eyes and penetrate their hearts to know there is a true and living God. Oh, Father, we just want to say thank you this morning. If I had 10,000, if I had 50,000, if I had 100,000, if I had 1,000,000, if I had 1,000,000,000, I couldn't tell you enough. But I'll use the one that you provide. His word says that this tongue can give life and it can take it away. It also can encourage, it can love.
Oh, yeah.
And we just want to say thank you, Father, for instilling that love one for another. Great is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Oh, Father, thank you for covering us, for walking with us through this holiday season. But thank you for walking through the doors of old Bethlehem and giving us peace unmerited favor. And it's in your name, Lord. The only name that I know, that's Jesus. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. It's in.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Amen. 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 Please stand, remain standing as our speaker will be coming forth. He's not a stranger to Bethlehem. I think he have a lot of history here. I think he might even have a wife in here. We have many, many, many relatives in here, friends, and family. So let us receive him. Reverend Benny Blake. Preach the word. Reverend Benny Blake. Teach the word. Reverend Benny Blake. Let God use you right now.
Is it? Deacon Swain.
So then Nahash, the Ammonite, came up and encamped against Jabesh Gilead. And all the men of Jabesh said unto Nahash, make a covenant with us, and we will serve thee. And Nahash the Ammonite answered them, on this condition I will make a covenant with you, that I may thrust out all your right eyes, and lay it for a reproach unto all Israel. And the elders of Jabesh said unto him, give us 7 days respite, that we may send messengers unto the coast of Israel. And then, if there be no man to save us, we will come out to thee. Mm-hmm. Then came the messengers to Gibeah of Saul. And he told the tidings in the ears of the people. And all the people lifted up their voices and wept. And behold, Saul came after the herd out of the field. And Saul said, what aileth the people that they weep? And they told him the tidings of the men of Jabesh. And the Spirit of God came upon Saul when he heard those tidings. And his anger was kindled greatly. And he took a yoke of oxen and hewed them in pieces and sent them throughout all the coast of Israel by the hands of messengers, saying, whosoever cometh not forth after Saul and after Samuel, so shall it be done unto his oxen. And the fear of the Lord fell on the people, and they came out with one consent. And when he numbered them in Bezek, the children of Israel were 300,000, and the men of Judah 30,000. And they said unto the messengers that came, thus shall ye say unto the men of Jabesh Gilead, tomorrow, by that time the sun be high, you shall have help. And the messengers came and showed it to the men of Jabesh, and they were glad.
Mission. It is your name? Repeat this after me. Hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Help.
Help.
It's on the way.
It's on the way.
Help.
Help.
It's on the way.
It's on the way.
Hold on. You might be going through something right now. Huh? But hold on. Psalm 121, 1, 2, 3, all of my help, all of my help, I will lift up my eyes to unto the hills from whence cometh my help. Huh? Lift up. I'm so glad the Lord has put in me not to be scared of nobody. No one used to go for them white folks. Mm-hmm. They say something to you. Mm-hmm. You look bad. Scratching in your ear. That ain't happening to me no more. I'm going to look at him. He's going to look at me. Huh? That's right. Hello, somebody. It was some government men. Jordan was reduced by the Amorites. They were having hell against them Amorites.
All right.
But help was on the way.
Yeah.
Huh? Help was on the way. Saul's great readiness to come to the relief whereby he singularized. Singularized meant himself.
Yep.
He singularized himself. The good success of his attempt by which God singularized.
Huh?
God specialized.
All right.
Hello, somebody. When God says something, it's there.
Yes, sir.
Isn't that right? God don't need no help. He don't need no rope dope like all he used to do. God can stand still.
Yeah.
And fight.
Yes,
sir. Isn't that right? I want to let you know, you might be going through something today, but help is on the way. Hello?
Press in.
Here we go. Here we go. Verse 1 through 4. The Amorites was bad neighbors. Those tribes of Israel, they had laid next to them to the descendants from just Lot. They inherited that. Huh? The Amorites wanted to take over. Hello, somebody. The Palestine and Israel, the Palestine want Israel to give them that land. But out of all the prisoners, Israel ain't gonna give them that land because God gave that land to Israel.
Right.
Hello, somebody. Every president I know since I've been big enough, no. They said, Israel shared the land with the Palestinians. God said, Israel shouldn't do nothing with the Palestine because God gave that land to Israel, and that's the way it is, and that's the way it's going to be. I don't care how many presidents say so. Hello. The city of Jezebel, the Gilead, had been some age ago. I was looking at that. I'm 74 years old. My name is Bennett Blake. My daddy was R.L. Blake. My mother was Helen Cole Blake. Somebody had something against them, against me, and 74 years later, they still got it against me.
All right. Well, say that.
Hello?
Say that.
It shouldn't be, but it is. That's what's going on right here. The Amorites was bad neighbors. We got some bad neighbors.
Uh-huh.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
We got some bad neighbors, right? In Tunis.
Right here.
Hello, somebody. Wrong work, can't spell work, but every time you move, they move.
Yep.
Hello?
Tell the truth.
Hello?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Wrong work, can't spell work, but you work, every time you move, they move. You see?
Yep.
But it's happening on the way.
Uh-huh.
Y'all ain't gonna be with me today.
I hear you.
Yes, sir.
The Amorites were bad neighbors to those tribes of Israel. Israel was God's first choice.
Yes, it was. Yes.
Hello?
Yeah.
Israel was God's first choice.
Yes, sir.
Hello? The Amorites were bad neighbors to those tribes of Israel that lay next to them, though the descendants from just Lot and from the region dealt civil by the Israel. The city of Jabesh, Gilead, had been some ages ago destroyed by Israel's sword of justice.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Young people down at the White House is trying to keep us from voting.
Sad.
Just last week in Houston, when we had to vote, Something happened, and they kept the polls on until 8 o'clock. And them Republicans said that those votes don't matter. Those votes shouldn't be counted. Huh? Y'all lost somebody? See what I'm saying? Yeah. But help is on the way.
Yes, it is.
Any all right?
Yeah.
Any all right?
Yeah.
Say yes over here.
Yes.
Yes. We moving. Notice the sin of this Gilbert. They said they would send messengers to the coast of Israel, which made Laish the more secure, for that he thought would be a work of time. But the messengers, either of their own accord or by the order from their master, went straight to Gilead, and not finding Saul within them, that told news to the people who fell weeping upon it. They told the wrong news. Is that right? You got to be careful who you talk to. Hello?
Yes.
You got to be careful who you associate yourself with.
Right.
You told them, don't tell nobody. You told them, don't tell nobody what y'all talk about. Boy, get out your mouth, it's in California. Then it said that Deacon Swain is no good. Hello? Okay.
We hear you.
When here related turns very much to the heart of Saul and shows the happy fruit of that other spirit which he would endure. His humility, though he was anointed king, Saul was anointed king. His humility, though he was anointed king and accepted by his people, yet he did not think it belonged him to know the state of his own flock, but went himself to see them and came in the evening with his servant after he had heard out of the field. Like Paul, he worked with his hand. See that? Paul worked with his hand. Paul was a tent maker. Hello? He worked with his hand. The Bible said, if you don't work, you ain't going to eat. Boy, Tuna would be in bad shape.
Yeah.
Tuna would be in bad shape if they didn't work, couldn't eat. Because there's a whole lot of
them.
And tunas won't work, can't spell work. But they eat. Hello?
Yes.
Yes.
His zeal for the safety of his honor and of Israel, when he heard of the Amorites and the distress of the city, the mother of Israel, the Spirit of God came upon him. And the Spirit of God came upon me and anointed me.
Say it so.
To preach the gospel.
Yes.
To the captive.
Yeah.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
To the free.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. The Spirit of God came upon me and has anointed me.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes.
It all right?
Yes. Come on, son.
Anointed.
His faith, confidence, his courage and resolution, his enterprise, he now sends back this assurance.
All right.
In which is probable Samuel encouraged him. Tomorrow, he said, tomorrow, by such an hour, before the enemy can pretend that the 7 days have expired, you shall have deliverance. Hello? Help is on the way.
Yes.
Is he all right?
Yes, sir.
Is he all right?
Yes.
Is he all right?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
He's all right.
Help, help, help. Yeah. Help is on the way.
I believe it's
when Barry told us in the study while ago, he said, I'm having an operation in front. I've had this operation before. But I was telling him, you helped me, because help is on the way.
Yeah.
He said, I promise you, I'll never leave you. I never forsake you.
Yeah.
Isn't it all right?
Yeah.
It's already taken place. All you got to do is show up. It's already happened.
Yes,
the Lord's like, you can't. You can't. Because the Lord is in the operating room.
Yeah.
Isn't it all right?
Yeah.
Isn't it all right?
Yeah.
This was good news to the besieged Gileads.
Mm.
When they heard it, they were glad.
Yes, yes.
Huh? That was good news. Several years ago, when I had cancer.
Yeah, yeah.
On my brain.
Well.
I told my wife, I was having a problem. She said, well, we need to go to the doctor. Mm. I went to the doctor. They checked it. There was something up there. Mm-hmm. She told me to come back. Went back. It still was up there. Third time I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, whatever it is going on up there, if it's in your will you remove it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
Hello, somebody.
Hello.
Is he all right?
Yeah.
Is he all right?
Yeah,
is he all right up in here? My wife took me back to the doctor the third time.
Come on, son.
Went in there, she said, Bennett, whatever was up there, it's gone.
Yeah.
Is it all right?
Yeah.
Didn't take no radiation, didn't take no one iron donation. But Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say
Jesus.
Jesus, my rock.
Yeah.
In the weary land. Shelter. In the stomach blood. Say yes.
Yeah.
Say yes.
Yeah.
We wiped it out. That's why. I was in the bed that night. Lord took his hand. Took his hand. But right, I'm aware. I'm laying there. I'm aware. He took his hand and did that right there. Or he left, he said, you're here. Hallelujah!
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 Hallelujah! Is he all right? Is he all right? Is he all right? Say yes! Say yes!
He's a way maker.
He's a way maker. He's on time, though.
Yes.
Huh? Might not come when you want it,
yeah.
But he always on time.
Always.
Is he all right?
Yeah.
Is he all right?
It's always. Never too late.
Help is on the way. We're going to get out of here.
I believe you.
Luke 9. 13-17. But he said unto her, give to him. They said, we have no more than 5 loaves, 2 fish, except we should go and buy food for all this people. Help us on the way. For they was about 5,000.
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh? They was about 5,000. He said to them, his disciples, make them sit down by 50s. They have been walking.
Come on.
They have been walking. They told Jesus, and Jesus told his disciples to make them sit down in 50s. Huh? It was 5,000.
Come on.
should go and buy food for these people. But there were about 5,000 men, and he said unto the disciples, make them sit down by 50 in a company.
Huh?
Yeah. And they did so. Mm-hmm. And made them all sit down. Then he took the 5 loaves.
Well.
Huh? The 5 loaves. I said, I couldn't have been in that bunch because I could have took care of that myself. And then he took the 5 loaves, 2 fish, and looked up to heaven. Look up there. He blessed them, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, and set before the multitude. And they did eat. It did eat and was filled, and there was taken up fragment that remained 12 baskets.
Amen.
Now read the 12 baskets. Because when the 12 was with Jesus, the 5,000 was walking, they was home. The 12 with Jesus, they went home because they went Jesus. Because Jesus is the bread of life.
All right.
Hey! Hello? So when the fragments, when the 12 bats of fragments got up, Jesus told them, that's for the disciples. They can eat that.
Yeah.
Is he all right?
Yeah.
Is he all right?
Yes,
bread of heaven, bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Hello? Genesis 22. Genesis 22:1 and 14. And it came to pass of these things that God did test Abraham. God will test us.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
And it came to pass after these things that God did test Abraham.
All right.
And he said unto him, Abraham, and he said, behold, behold me, look. Behold, here am I. Abraham said, here am I. He said, take now thy son, thy only son, Isaac, whom thou lovest. Abraham loved Isaac.
Yep.
Because Isaac was only born, only son. He said, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. And Abraham rose up in the morning and saddled his pony. His ass pony. He rose up early in the morning, saddled his ass, and took 2 of his young men with him. And Isaac his son, and cut the wood for the burnt offering, and rose up and went into the place of which God had told him. Watch this.
Yeah.
We almost through. Then on the third day, 72 hours later,
yeah.
He got up. Then on Thursday, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off. And Abraham said unto his young men, abide. Stay. Abide and stay.
The burnt offering,
yeah.
and instead of his son,
mm-hmm.
And Abraham called the name of that place.
Yes.
Yes.
Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Rapha.
Yes. Yes.
As it says to this day, in the moment of the Lord, it shall be seen. Last one. St. John 6. 1. After these things, Jesus went over to the Sea of Galilee and the Sea of Tiberias. And a great multitude followed him because they saw his miracle, which he did on those which were diseased. And Jesus went up into a mountain that he sat with his disciples.
Yes.
And the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was near. And when Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company under him, he said unto Philip, "Where shall we buy bread that these may cast on the table?" Come on, John 5. John 5. John 5. And put him in. After this was the feast of the Jews. Mm-hmm. Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep gate, a pool which is called the Hebrew tongue, Bathsheba, having five porches.
Yeah.
And in that lay a great multitude of important folks. A blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the movement of the water.
Mm-hmm.
Watch this. For an angel went down at certain seasons into the pool and troubled the water.
Mm.
Whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in, was made well, and whatever disease he had.
Mm.
And a certain man was there who had infirmity 30 and 8 years.
Mm.
He'd been sitting around that pool for 30 and 8 years. Watch it. And when he saw him lying there and knew that he had been thus there a long time, he said unto him, "Will thou be made well?"
Mm.
Is he all right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yes,
is he all right? The important man asked him, "Sir, I have no man when the water's troubled to put me into the pool. But while I'm coming, another step down before me."
Mm.
Huh? And Jesus said unto him,
"Rise.
Pick
up thy bed.
Rise.
Yes.
Take up thy bed and walk."
Yes.
And immediately the man was made well.
Mm.
Took up his bed, walked, and said in the same day was the Sabbath.
Mm-hmm.
Trump, help. He's on the way.
Yeah.
Help.
Yeah.
Huh? Help. Help is on the way.
Yeah.
All you gotta do, hold on.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. Just get stopped on the road, frustrated. Car won't start. You call somebody. So hold on! I'll be there in a minute! Come up in there. Put the battery cable on there. You back on the road. Is it all right?
Yep.
Jesus hooked the battery cable up. Hello? Jesus hooked the battery cable up.
Got
to start it. I'm back on the road. Back on the road again?
Yes.
Back on the road again?
Yes.
On the road again? Hold on. Help. He's on the way.
Amen.
Amen. Just meditate on the words of this song, because
I don't know what you've been through, and you don't know what I've been through. But we all have been through something. Can I get a witness? And sometimes it seems like the weight of the world just press us down. Seems like and every time we try to do the right thing, evil press on every hand. Am I right about it?
Yep, it was the only way.
But I read in my Bible, Hebrews the 13th chapter,
yes,
in the 5th verse, he said, I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. He said, I'm more for you than the whole world could ever be against you. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? I don't know about you tonight, but I want you to know, I want you to listen to the words of this song. And it ain't much to it. It's just something to let you know that everything gonna be all right. Listen.
Well.
Yeah.